Hello and welcome to our series on ecological design modeling. In this series of lessons, you'll be learning about how to model ecosystems to understand how they function better, and then also how to design them. So what we're going to be looking at as an example would be if we had algae growing in a lake. This algae is present in the lake as organisms, and when sun is added to the lake, this algae grows and multiplies, and you get more algae. And fairly soon, after a while, if conditions are correct, you'll have lots of algae. So we have a lake with algae, and this grows by sunlight. Sun. And the algae die. So we have death of algae. So we have a process where there's a flow of energy driving biological production to create an ecosystem. And then there's death of the organisms. So there's a cycle. There's a storage of algae and two flows, growth. And to be able to model the storage of algae, which maybe we will symbolize as A, and then we have sunlight as a source of energy to make new algae. And then there is death of algae. And as the algae dies, it releases energy that can no longer be used. So we have energy going to our heat sink. So we have growth of algae, and we have death of algae. So we'll be able to turn this into a differential equation, which we will then put into a simulation model and a spreadsheet. So we have the change per time, D, of algae, which is our main storage. And that equals the flow of new algae, growth, minus death. And what we'll learn to do is to symbolize and model both of these flow processes so that we'll have an inflow of new growth and death that's dependent on the amount of algae that's there. So our differential equation now as A on both sides. And we can see that the change in algae is a function of the amount of algae. We will then take this and use spreadsheet software to simulate the model. And then we'll be able to ask what if questions to say, well, what happens if I have more sunlight? What if I have higher death rate? So what we'll be able to do with our model is plot the change or the storage over time. So we'll be able to make time series graphs of A, our storage. Maybe it's increasing over time. Or possibly death is higher than growth, and we might see that it declines over time. One other thing we'll be able to do is determine what our coefficient here, our K in our equation, and that's called calibration. And then we'll also learn a step that's important in modeling to understand whether our models are representing reality, called validation. So these are the things we had to look forward to in these series of lessons.